Let's go.
What up, everybody? It's your boy, Redneck Tupac. I've made my return for episode 6 of the Locust Street podcast. By the way, anything you hear or see in this video, we own no rights to. You have to do that.
No, yeah.
You have to do that homie G skillet biscuit slice. Like, you know.
What? Skillet biscuit flights?
Slice. Like home slice, you know, like home slice. Skillet fried biscuit.
Heard that.
It sounds like a dish from the farm.
And I'm here with the other two creators of the podcast. The Dominican Dre and the Jewish Larry Bird.
What up?
So, you know.
Every different podcast, we got different names.
Not Jewish.
You shouldn't be saying that, actually. Maybe
all of the Jews. All of them.
Jews, you can't say that. You get in trouble.
What do you mean we say that? I'm saying they're welcome. Everybody is, right? Isn't that what we're talking about? Or okay, yes. Everybody's
hey,
welcome.
Hey, and on that note, happy Hanukkah. To all my Jewish people out there.
High five for that one.
Hanukkah started the Festival of Lights.
So a lot has changed here in the little bit of time that we have been gone from the podcast. We've all had different things going on and all that shit. I have more baby mama drama. Let's see. My old lady left me. That's about all that's been happening in my life.
And then baby mama drama.
Yeah, crazy baby mama drama. Yeah. Crazy ass fucking baby mama. You know,
this is what happened to me. So my job as a painter is completely slow. And then second job, restaurant, dishwasher, you know, just for the hell of it. Got replaced until it gets busy for one of the guys in the line that cooks. So I'll be back, bitches. That's what happened. What happened to you?
What's happened to you in these last couple months there, Hebrew?
Nothing exciting. I've really got nothing to bring to the table.
You got raped over a table?
No, I've got nothing to bring to the table.
Rape over a table.
He got raped over a table, ladies and gentlemen. That's what happened to him in the last couple months since we made our episode 5.
That's your ears must be super dirty. But, yeah, he got raped over a table, guys.
Not true. Poor Alejandro Frijole.
Fake news. #fake news.
Hashtag Fox.
I think we should fucking burn that fucking painting that Goose's ex gave to us.
Yeah, you keep telling that. You mentioned that on the...
What do you think, Goose?
What?
You mentioned that every time we're all together. Fucking,
it's Redneck Tupac.
Yes.
Pac. What do you think about burning that fucking...
Redneck Pac.
What do you think about burning that fucking painting?
No, because it's actually a nice piece of art. And I actually have a thing for nice pieces like that.
Okay, all right.
No, I mean, it was a gift to you. I don't want you doing something like that just on that account, brother. It's a nice piece.
If I burn it, you'll be okay with it?
Yeah, I mean, because it's yours. But it's a nice piece of art. It's a nice piece of art,
but I don't know how the way that she ended. Yeah. I don't know how I felt about that. So I might want to...
I don't know.
You know, like, if I go back to the Dominican Republic in 1946... Or 1956. Mm. Yeah, 56. We were telling all the Americans, go home, Yankee, because they wanted to take over my land.
Sure.
It's that, you know, like...
Probably on a ship like that.
Camera's on you, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, people. Is this where I'm doing this for my...
We'll upgrade one day. Don't worry about it.
But we all got to start somewhere.
No shit.
Santa's bringing us some new equipment for the studio.
Yeah. You got Jewish Larry Bird over here drinking his
Mango Mike's Hard Lemonade.
Mike's Hard.
They had me to drive?
Yes. But dude, the baby mama bullshit, bro, has been fucking something else, dude. I went over to my friend Jody's earlier, lives above my kids, dude, and fucking I'm like, I went up there just to smoke with her and shit, and fucking Miranda figured out I was there and told the kids she wanted them to come home, which is fine. I got to see him for a good 45 minutes, almost an hour. But yeah, dude, the baby mama, for those of you that have a really chill baby mama and that don't have any bullshit, yo, you know, like, count your blessings. Dude, she literally showed up here, Bean, and caused an episode where Big Mike which I know he'll see this at some point.
What was this?
Monday.
Cop
showed up? Yo, yeah, cop showed up earlier in the day. Like
5-0's, man.
Jack was here for that.
Who's Jack?
The other, the new guy upstairs.
Blackjack.
Yeah. But yeah, dude, friggin'.
No black gay!
It made our landlord friggin' literally walk in the front door and turn around and walk back out because he said she didn't want no smoke from him. Because he knew what was up. He knew the assignment. But if he had gotten involved, she'd have said something stupid to him. And our boy is not one of those type of dudes. Like, he'll
that
check.
Was before I went to work, right?
Yeah, they showed up around 4:30.
Yeah, but then you guys came down. Mike was here. And then he gave me a ride to work. And that's when you said it to the cops. You missed the show.
Yeah, yeah. That's.
She picked up the kids, right?
Yeah, she had come by with a friend and picked up the kids, even though I told her they'd be home by between 6:30. So we have all this court-ordered stuff. I have this magical paperwork that when I pulled it out on the cops, they were ready to handcuff me, bro. Like, one of them had their hands on their handcuffs.
Yeah, it's like kidnapping, nigga. You pick up the kids at 2 o'clock from the school without the mom knowing?
I can't. And that's the real kicker, ladies and gentlemen. I can't get a hold of this bitch. Because she's blocked me on everything. I can't text her. I can't call her. I did tell the school when I got there. They know about all that. And
yeah,
I told
so
them.
That's why they let you take them.
Yeah, she asked the school why. And they're like, because they called her to let her know at like 2:30 or whatever it was.
You're lucky you didn't get shot.
But I asked them.
Hot take.
That's true.
The cops thought about it. Like, she called the cops, right? And that's the only reason they came to your house. Why? Because she was like, my kids, baby father picked them up according to the fucking school or whatever, picked them up at 2 o'clock and took them without my permission. But the fact that she didn't know that it's Monday and Tuesday, whatever days you have with the kids legally.
Yep.
And to the fact that she blocked you from every fucking social media, contacts, texts, whatever. She probably was like, you kidnapped.
But the thing is,
and then the cops saw you and you showed them that, and then they were like,
it states
you're
that
good,
yeah,
you're good, yes,
but. Yeah. They even said, you want to call the lieutenant and let him know that there's nothing we can do here. Literally, that's what they said to my face. And then they were like, well, we're sorry for the inconvenience. And they asked if this is going to be a constant thing. I said, yes, it probably will be. But they've already seen the paperwork. They've already got it
so
down. Yeah, so in the paperwork, I don't need her permission to do anything. If I want to show up at her house and be like, all right, guys, we're going out for ice cream, especially on Monday and Tuesdays, the parties agreed.
Or Wednesday Monday and Thursday.
Right, Monday or Tuesday. It was Monday, Tuesdays, which is perfect for me. Perfect for them. And now she just thinks that where our days of the week weren't set in stone, which it doesn't matter. In my paperwork, it states I have two days and two nights. Like, I can have them 3.5 days out of the week if I wanted to, and give her 3.5. I should fucking do that, but I'm not going to because they like being with their friends and at the complex and everything. So I don't like taking them away from all their friends. You know, that's why they rarely ever come here. But yeah, dude. But everybody, she's a fucking psycho, bitch. Fucking psycho, bro. Fucking dude. Like, literally. I can't wait till I go up north with them, because
she's not a psycho. She just wants her way. A psycho is a girl that follows you, and then like just appear every time wherever you at. Surprise, motherfucker! You thought you were going to your boy's house, but you're over here at your other boy's house. That's a psycho.
Funny.
She's just not.
She's just not happy. Yeah. Well, I hate to tell you, but
not a lot of us are happy, but we fucking.
But see, I also look at it this way, that I'm the type of father that, you know, is like a stand-up dad. You know what I mean? According to everybody, because I also look at how many kids do you know, that, especially around here, that grow up without dads. You know what I mean? That don't have a man. The man doesn't want to be in their lives. But I'm a dad that's the opposite of all of that. I do everything I can, like, you know. I suffer in the little ways, you know what I mean? Like, you know, I'm constantly on the move. Like, if I have to drop everything I'm doing at work,
yeah.
I have to. Like, I have to go. The second my kids call me crying, I'm gone, dude.
What time is it now?
8:07.
Almost
eight.
Time for Patriots.
But we're on the side of the United States that it gets dark at 4. So if my kids call me right now with some problem, I will get there either way, like in a second. Or if not, like in an hour while I'm running, because I don't have.
So out of all three of us, I've had the most interesting last like couple months. It's been great. It's wonderful. Fabulous. Yeah.
Can't believe you brought Breakneck Tupac out on the podcast. Two identities, people. Two identities.
Three, actually. You got wow. Aaron, Goose, and now Redneck Tupac.
You're still giving up your government name. Stop doing that.
Three different personalities. Three different people.
Oh, yeah, because Aaron is one, and then Goose is the other one.
And Redneck Tupac is the mix of the two. Like, in Dragon Ball Z, when they do the high Kamikawa, whatever, when they touch, like, the fingertips, and they come and become one person.
What?
Fingertips?
What?
Yeah, I don't know.
I'll have to show you. You'll understand what I mean.
I know when they do Super Saiyan. Super Saiyan!
Yeah. But what they do is when they do this with each other.
What is the fuck?
And they bend over.
Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Z?
He's a rich kid. He wouldn't know anything about poor kid shows.
Thank you. You know what? You took the words out of my mouth.
Sounds like some gay shit.
That's a good meatloaf song.
No, it's animation. It's animation. Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah, whatever. I'm a G.I. Joe kid.
You should watch it. And then, yeah, G.I. Joe, seriously?
Ninja Turtles.
Fuck. Yeah, I did that too. But, like, Dragon Ball Z was epic, bro.
Yeah, I don't think so.
You should watch it. That means you're like super way old.
Yeah, I know. Younger than
but
Lewis.
But even if you're
younger
old.
I'm younger than Lewis, everybody. Just want to go on.
I'm younger than the both of them.
No, I know. Yeah, Goose is like. See, this is where we like. You want to. Yeah, he's like in his 30s. I'm in my 40s.
This a lot guy, of hair on this motherfucker here.
Yeah, he's got great jeans.
Yeah.
The Wranglers.
Just letting you know, ladies. Ladies and men. Or both. This man's single.
Available.
Ready.
Who's single? That guy?
That guy.
So is Lewis.
So is Lewis, yep. If you like some Dominican chocolate in your life, you hit up this sexy fuck.
That was creepy.
His pet peeves are being called Bubby.
Oh, come on. You really?
Cut.
That word doesn't come out the character of... That comes out of the other ones. Yeah, Uji boo boo. Fucking pussy.
But yes, they're both single.
So gay.
You know, they're both single and ready to mingle.
You are what? What are you?
Yeah, no shit.
I'm a goose.
Are you freshly, are you newly,
I'm a redneck Tupac inside of a market? Goose's skin.
He's a newly bachelor. Yeah. We're looking for Ramona. I'm gonna, hey, any ladies, put it back.
Who's Listen, Ramona?
Any ladies that would like this redneck Tupac, real quick.
Hit the like button.
For now, it's redneck Tupac, but like, he looks different. Yeah, hold this real quick. Any ladies that their name is Ramona, please contact this YouTube thing. And it's going. So yeah, Ramona, call Goose.
My Sharona.
You might get a Dominican Ramona, Puerto Rican Ramona, Mexican Ramona, or a white girl that's Ramona.
Caucasian.
Caucasian. Sorry, Caucasians. Chinese Ramona, maybe. I don't know.
Ah, mi la violanta. Tupuku.
Anyways, but yeah, that's what I think.
Yeah, so, you know, it's been an eventful little bit of time here, but this is episode 6, and, you know...
This was 7.
Episode 6. The other video was just the introduction for episode 6. It was like a commercial, coming soon. Yeah. I know I hyped this video up, but you know what I mean? What better than the three original creators, you know?
How many likes we got?
None. Negative three.
Well, that's because I don't share it to your Facebook.
We got dislikes.
I don't share it to people's Facebooks. I don't do any of that because I just...
Yeah, because if my mom saw this, she'd fucking have a heart attack.
Why?
Because she's a fucking...
I'm sorry for any of my family and people that see this. Can't help it. I'm white, but the hood love me.
No, I don't care about YouTube. There's no way...
Yes, but if I put it on your Facebook, it's going to be on your...
On my don't tag me on Facebook.
That's what I mean. That's how we're not getting people out. You know what I mean?
You can tag me. I share the first one. It just depends. And I think the first one, we had bongs and shit.
Yeah, torches. That was when we were all outside and shit.
Yeah.
That's when
I posted that, and then I have a few.
Yeah, the girls are complete soft. They're like, Locust Street Gang, gang. A complete. Did I tell you about that?
No.
They said they give me, I walk in, they're all like, Locust Street Gang, gang. I'm like, what are these bitches talking about? They're like, we saw you guys balling out in the hood. What? I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about,
Leah? See, that's why we got to post you.
She's like, who's Luaz? I'm like, that's Shannon's friend. Oh my god.
Yeah, they'll mention Lewis, but they won't mention me. See? Isn't that fucked?
No, that's who they... It was people you might know on Facebook. He popped up. So she fucking went on there. She obviously... She's into border... Oh, excuse me. But, Dominicans.
What were you going to say?
She's into... She's
Hispanics.
Into Hispanic.
It seems like all women are into everybody but white guys. Sucks.
Not for me.
Is this our payback, bro?
This nigga was a fucking Mexican.
I object. I look. In the summertime, I look a little bit like I can pass for a Mexican.
No. Comics. I'm saying you date.
Oh yeah.
Ninja girl.
Ninja bitch. Yeah, she's like from. She's New Mexican.
No, she's still so Spanish.
Anyways, back to me. So what were we talking about?
About how you're string bean 69 on Grindr.
No, we weren't.
He likes to rub the fur, ladies and gentlemen.
No. Actually, I hate that. I'm glad Goose stopped doing it, actually, because it was disgusting. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. All the fur bean.
No, take a shot of it. All the viewers out there, it's disgusting.
This is what he wants.
Yeah.
He wants... Oh, yeah.
Sit down. Sit back down. Get away.
Yeah. He wants bean.
It's disgusting.
Rub
that bean.
Breakneck two plus fur.
That's right. Rub my fur.
I got a knife.
I don't know.
I'm getting a knife.
What?
I got a knife.
I was gonna grab a knife.
Get the machete. Right
there. Oh yeah, I forgot it was there.
That's why I have it there. Quick access.
Give me the axe, maybe.
That too.
Just chop. We couldn't do that for Goose. Maybe chop his pinky off. Teach him a lesson.
But if you do this. No, put your hand. Put your finger.
Right. I'm not gonna easy.
If you just do one chop, there's like at least two gone.
Let's not talk about it.
Pussy.
But yeah, we're running out of time, ladies and gentlemen, because I gotta create some more space on my phone. But this video will be up.
Ghetto fucking podcast.
That's we're right.
Next we here.
That's right.
105 locust bitches.
Dominican Dre. Fucking Hebrew cunt.
Jewish Larry Bird.
There you go.
And I've been your boy Redneck Tupac.
All day.
Stay tuned for episode 7.
All day.